Litre'nin elimi. Literacy is not only a right to us, but it is also needed if the citizens are to perform their duties and enjoy their rights properly. It means education or literacy is not our right only, but it is our requirements to perform our duties and to enjoy or to exercise our rights. It means education helps us to perform our duties and exercise our rights. A vast difference in literacy has been noticed on the basis of sex or on the basis of gender, on the basis of region, on the basis of caste, on the basis of class. Literacy among males is nearly 16.6% higher than the females. It means there is 16.6% literacy rate is higher of males as compared to females. In rural areas, in rural area also, literacy rate is 16.1% higher than the rural areas. On the basis of region, in 2000, literacy rate in Kerala was 94%, while in Bihar only 62%. Thus we see that literacy rate varies from region to region, gender to gender, class to class, caste to caste also. Unfortunately, this huge expansion of the primary school system to fill up this gap of the differences or variation of literacy rate, the primary school system has been expanded. To over 7.68 lakhs in 2004-05. It means in 2004-05, the primary school system has been expanded and the number of primary school became 7.68 lakhs. But unfortunately, this huge expansion of schools has been diluted. But this expansion of school has poor quality of education. This primary school system is equipped with poor quality of education. And high dropout rates. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan is also a significant step of the government towards providing elementary education to all children of the age of 14 years, 6 to 14 years. It is a time-bound initiative of the central government in partnership of the states, the local government and the community to achieve the goals to increase or enhance the literacy rate of the country, the literacy rate in the population. Along with it, bridge courses and back-to-back school camps have been initiated to increase the enrollment in elementary education. It means to increase the enrollment in elementary education, that along bridge courses and back-to-back school camps schemes have been initiated by the government. Midday meal was introduced to encourage attendance and retention of the children in primary schools. These policies could add to the literate population of India. All these schemes have been initiated by the government to add the literate population of India. The 11th plan is to increase the enrollment in higher education of the 18 to 23 years age group to 15% by 2011-12. It means to increase the enrollment in the higher education, 11th plan focused and increased from 15% to 21%. The strategy focuses on increasing access. It means on what the 11th plan of education focuses. So the 11th educational plan focuses on increasing access to the educational institution to make qualitative education, adoption of a state-specific curriculum, modification of the state-specific curriculum, vocationalization, networking on the use of information technology. This plan also focuses on the distant education, convergence of formal and non-formal education, IT education, etc. Over the past 50 years, there has been a significant growth in the number of university and institutions of higher learning or higher institutions have increased. This data given in your text reveals that increasement in the number of university, the number of educational institutions like schools and colleges, increasement in the number of teachers, increasement in the enrollment of the students, etc., about which we will discuss in next class. Dear students, at last, I would like to tell you that what education plays important role in our life or in our in making human resources. Dear students, first of all, if question is asked that how does education play significant role in making human resources, then you can answer as education is undeniable one of the most important aspects of life of the people. It helps us to develop as people as we grow. It means as we grow from childhood, education helps us to develop as people. It helps us to learn new life skills of production of goods and services. It improves our knowledge. It helps us to carry all the information in our daily life. It helps us to become better and more informed citizens. It helps enables us to lead happier and more successful lives, as we find in the case study of Sakal and Vilas. That due to education, Sakal led happier and more successful life, in contrast of Sakal, in absence of education, Vilas led not so more happier and successful life as compared to Sakal. Dear students, in next class, we will discuss about the another quality of population, health. Okay? Thank you.